Good morning and welcome to New Day Northwest. Starting things off are the answers to burning fashion questions that have been on our viewers' minds, apparently. So stylist Darcy Camden is here with the answers. These are things that clients and viewers ask you all the time.
And I love it when people ask me questions, by the way. I always get emails or on Twitter or people stop me in Target and
yes.
say, what do you think?
As well we should. So question number one, I'm going to a wedding and I'm wearing a sleeveless dress. What should I take as a cover up to wear if it gets windy or chilly? Which it would never do in the Pacific Northwest.
And it's good that we're starting with this one because this is maybe my number one question that I get asked this time of year. You're going to a fancy event, you want a little arm coverage, you want warmth, but like a jean jacket or a regular cardigan doesn't feel fancy.
Isn't gonna work.
Okay, so we have a model showing.
Come on out. I always
tell everyone, go to Eileen Fisher.
Oh.
And go to the store.
Oh, look.
And this is so lovely. So this is a wrap sweater cardigan hybrid that is, it's like a silk, lovely, elegant wrap.
Does it have sleeves at all, or it just goes
It does
over?
Not have okay. sleeves, so it's going to just sort of drape over the shoulder,
That's
but it keeps
pretty.
You warm. It's elegant. It's a little bit of an investment piece. It's about $200. But if you can save on the dress, so the dress here was under $50, or maybe you could do rent the runway, get something mm-hmm. around $30, and then invest in something that you can wear over and over and over again. This one comes in three colorways. This is kind of like a an icy blue, but it comes in
Beautiful.
Black and kind of an ivory, and I just love it so much.
The ivory would be great. And what's cool about that is that you still get to see her beautiful dress.
Yes.
It isn't long and flowy in the front. It's just the stuff
covering
behind.
It up. Sometimes I call that death by cardigan when you have a beautiful
yes.
dress, and then you end up covering it up completely with some cardigan. This
so
has
true.
Flow and elegance, and you can wear that if you want a little arm coverage or a little warmth.
Spectacular. Thank you. Thank you very much to our model. Okay, next question. I'm a plus size. Can I wear a jumpsuit?
Easy. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, totally.
But you got to find the right, all of us have to find the right one.
Petite women also ask me this question.
Yes.
And I just don't think there should be any restrictions. Age, size, if you're interested in something, you should definitely try it, see if it works for you.
Go to
I went
it.
To Torrid at Alderwood Mall, and they had, which is a store that specializes in sizes 10 to size 30 in women's wear, and they had no less than 6 different jumpsuits.
Yay,
so
I love that
So for everyone,
one.
Any size, no matter size, if you're trying a jumpsuit for the first time, you wanna go for something wide leg and a soft, crepey, flowy, stretchy fabric.
Okay.
And our model Sade would probably agree that this is so comfortable because it's light and stretchy. It's like pajamas. You could fall asleep in it. There are some jumpsuits in the market that are more tapered at the leg with less stretch, and those are harder just across the board for everyone. So you want something with a little bit of a wider leg. A solid color is pretty universally flattering, as is vertical stripes.
Those
as
stripes
we see here.
So pretty up and down like that. That looks great. And you just put a little jean jacket and a hat and off you go.
And a shout out to Torrid also for a great selection of wide shoes.
Oh, interesting.
And I know a lot of people are like, where can I find wide shoes?
That's a
Nordstrom
good
does not have a great selection in wide. And Torrid, I was loving their selection of flats and espadrilles and wedges. So if you need a wide shoe, head there. They have a great selection.
Perfect. All right. So the third question that you get all the time is, what do I wear under white? White pants, white tops. How do we position our undergarments in just the right way?
Oh, totally. Okay, my new favorite undergarments are by Knix, K-N-I-X.
Okay.
You can shop online at knix.com, or they have a new pop-up at U Village that's gonna be open through the end of August.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what you wanna get for white pants. This is the Thigh Saver Short. So it's kind of like Spanx, but unlike Spanx, you don't wear underwear underneath it. This is the underwear. And it is sweat wicking and all of that stuff. We don't want to get too gross, but it's, you know.
And it doesn't roll up at the legs or anything?
It does not roll
wow.
up. So comfortable to wear. I just love that. And you always want to do a nude under white, whether it's mm-hmm. a white t-shirt, white pant, never white under white. That shows the most. So you want to go nude under white always if you want it to disappear. So that I think is great under a pant or a white dress.
And then you have these little tops. What are these?
The other thing that NYX has that I love, these are like sweat guard t-shirts. Mm-hmm. And I wear these in the summer. I wear them in the winter too, but especially in the summer if I don't want to get like a sweat stain or any sort of smell on like a blouse or a t-shirt or a dress. This kind of just disappears under my clothes. And then that's your sweat guard right there. So this is their Don't Sweat It tee.
And smooths
and
as well.
And it smooths, it does all of that. It's kind of like your Spanx and your sweat guard all in one.
All in one. Okay, question four, how can I keep my makeup from sweating off on hot days? And where does it go anyway is my question. Where does it go?
Into the universe.
And what is your favorite face SPF lotion that isn't greasy or thick? So two challenging things here.
Okay, this is about to be your new summer obsession.
Da-da-da-da.
So this is by a brand called Super Goop! Exclamation point. Mm-hmm. This is their Setting Mist Defense Refresh Broad Spectrum with SPF 50. So it is a makeup setting spray. I'm gonna spray it on myself. And you can get a little smell. It smells just light. It has sort of like a minty, herbally sort of smell. It's super light. So that's gonna set your makeup. Mm. And it also has your SPF 50 in it.
Seriously.
So SPF 50, if you're in direct sunlight, you're gonna wanna reapply that every hour and a half.
That's very interesting. I've got their actual regular just sun spray, but that's even better.
Love it. Super light. And this, so this is $28. And then I also carry like a little one of these, which is $12. I carry that in my purse. My favorite SPF for face is by La Roche-Posay. A little bit expensive, so it's $30, but one of these will last me, I mean, months. And it is just the most, honestly, lightweight, disappearing.
Ooh. Where do you get it?
Mattifying. Drugstores, Ulta, Target even has it. And honestly, it disappears. It's so light. It's so much different than any of the other facial. Works amazing.
We will put that on the website. Don't worry if you didn't write it down. Okay, question number five. What is the right way to cut jeans into shorts? Because if you do it the wrong way, you've got a problem.
Totally. You can waste a pair of good jeans.
You really can. And sometimes, you know, you're just tired of them. You've got new jeans and you want to make shorts out of the old ones. I don't know how to do this. How do you do it?
So there is a right way and a wrong way, and there's also a trend. So the trend right now is longer, almost Bermuda style, thinner, like slim leg. So this is great for your skinny jeans, like anything where the knee is stretched out or maybe they're too short, because you're going to cut that off anyway. So I measure down 10 inches on the inseam and I mark it with chalk, 10 inches. You can always cut up a little bit more if that's a little long for you. And then you take a ruler and you're going to go diagonal upwards about an inch. So not straight across, diagonal up. And then you draw a line.
Alrighty. Same thing on the other side.
Same thing on the other side.
So up about an inch.
Up about an inch. And through the magic of TV, we're
starting
one
right here. And why are we doing this?
That way it wears straight across. So the angle, once it gets on your body.
Because if you cut it straight across, it's going to hitch up.
Exactly. And that, I think, is the key part of it. So then you just cut it. If you want to fray it.
That was my next question.
Yeah, you can use a little sandpaper.
Oh, really?
And just use a little sandpaper to kind of
No. Tell me more. How do I do that? What do you mean?
So you would take, I wish I had some, but if you take some sandpaper
and do the
go along the edge and it will just kind of pull it out. Or you can throw it in the wash, but that's a way to do it if you want to just cut and wear.
You could use that sandpaper also if you're just cutting the hem off, right, to make cool frayed jeans.
Yeah.
Awesome. Let's
and you can
model.
Do a little roll up if you'd like.
I like it.
Yeah.
Then you have longer or shorter, whichever you want.
Yeah.
Let's see our model come on out, please.
So there she is in a nice longer short, which I think is great. So flattering.
Yeah, that looks good.
Yeah, and I love it with just a little easy men's shirt, little neck scarf, little loafer. That's a great summer look.
That is. Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you.
I will post this segment on my Facebook page today, too, because I know people have asked these questions, and we will
keep
pump the
questions
the answers
coming, guys.
Out there.
We love answering them.
Thank you so much.